Can you see now? Cylindrical contact? Yeah?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, previous class, what we did was we learnt about spherical contact and we solved a few problems on spherical contact. Now, we'll move on to cylindrical contact. Okay. So, cylinder, you have two cylinders like this. Okay. And I'll come to that. Yeah. So cylindrical contact, we have plenty of examples, you know, for making thin sheets, that is to control GSM of the paper, okay, through machinery. There we'll have example of cylindrical contact. Then in case of making sheets, okay, steel sheets of various thicknesses, okay, this contact is used, that is the sheet will be passed through rollers, okay. So, and then its thickness will be controlled. So, there we'll have cylindrical contact. Okay. And also, another best example is roller bearings. Okay. So, roller bearings are another example of cylindrical contact. And in all these examples, or you can take off, think of a tire on road surface. Okay. So, in all these examples, you can see that there is going to be rolling as well as sliding, okay, that will happen in case of roller cylindrical contact. Okay, so if you have a roller bearing, so you'll have a roller, okay, on the surface which is rolling, that is inner race of the bearing, these rollers will be rolling. Okay, so you can have plenty of such examples in cylindrical contact. So the presence of tangential sliding forces has a significant effect on stresses compared. So the high stress or high load zone is at the point of contact, that is Pmax. So whatever that I have shown here, okay, is at this juncture, that is where there is going to be a contact between the two cylinders. Is that okay? You are going to get Pmax over there, maximum load. And A is the distance of contact, okay, that is the edge length that we call. So two cylinders in pure rolling example is this. So now what you do is note down this sketch first. Note down this sketch. This is R2, radius of big second roller is R2, radius of the another roller is R1. So this will go like this, and that is, this is R1, this is R2. Radius of this is R1. And radius of the second roller is R2. Okay, that is depicted here as R1 and R2. They are in contact.
In which
manner stack works? Please note down the sketch.
In stack data structure, process of inserting an element is called.
The heading is pressure distribution in cylindrical contact.
the stack if the user tries to remove an element from the empty stack, then what is it called as? What will be the initial value of POP pointing to?
Finished, huh?
What will be initial value?
Yes, sir.
Finished the noting down?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So look at the derivation part, small derivation. Okay. So the contact pressure is P max at the center. Okay. That's what we have taken here. So P max is the contact pressure, that is maximum contact pressure. And the load applied is F, okay, on the contact patch. And that will be equal to volume of half prism. So that is F is equal to half pi A L into P max. So from that, you can extract the value of P max. Okay. So from the volume of half prism, we can extract the value of P max. Then average pressure is the applied force by contact patch area. Contact patch area is this, okay? This is 2A, this is A and A. So this is going to be taken as 2A, okay? This is A here, okay? 2A into L, that is projected area of this rectangle, okay? Are you there? Are you there? Of the surface?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is nothing but the area of the rectangle that we have taken over here. So that is pressure average is equal to load by area. So 2A into L, that is the projected area of the rectangle that we have got. So F by 2AL will give you P average. So substitute this F by 2AL into P max equation. Okay. Substitute into P max equation. What we are going to get is P max is equal to 1.273 times P average. Okay. And then cylindrical geometry constant depends on radii R1 and R2. So what is R1 and R2? Is the radius of cylinder 1 and radius of cylinder 2. Is that okay? So that is the R1 and R2 here. So cylindrical geometry constant, that is the value of B, depends upon R1 and R2 given by half of 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2. And again, going by previous classes discussion, we can say if cylinder R2 is a plane, okay, that is if you have a tire, that is the tire on a road surface, okay, tire on a road surface. So this is going to be R2, radius of the road surface. So that's obviously is going to be infinity. So 1 by R2 becomes 0. Okay. And if it is a cylinder in trough, that means if you have a trough like this and you have a cylinder within that, going by previous discussion again. So this is R2. Okay. So that R2 is going to be negative. Is that okay? So what we have taken is, we have taken F. From there, we extracted P max. Then we know what is average pressure given by force by projected area. Okay, from there, I extract the value of P max. Then cylindrical geometry constant B depends upon R1 and R2. So R2 is going to be 0 if it is a flat surface, and negative if it is in trough. Okay, and then we get the equation for contact patch, half width A. Okay, so that is A equation. M1 and M2, these constants we have taken, that is material constants we have taken in the previous class itself. Do you remember what we have taken? The values of M1 and M2. Okay, we have taken M1 and M2 as 1 minus nu 1 square by E1 and M2 as metal constant 1 minus nu 2 square by E2. Is that okay? Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, coming back to this. So, this is the constant B that we just noted down. Load F. L is the length of contact. M1 and M2 are material constants. And then the pressure distribution within the semi-elliptical prism is given by P is equal to P max into 1 minus X square by A square. And then the Hertzian stress distribution in parallel cylindrical contact is a plane stress and plane strain depending upon cylinder, whether a cylinder is short or cylinder is long. Okay. If it is very long, we take it as a plane strain. If it is very short, we consider it as plane stress. Okay. And then we are going to go move on to the problem. Now, what you do is you have noted down this sketch, note down this derivation like. Note down this completely. Okay. Please note down this. Okay. Cylindrical contact. There will be definitely one question, like one problem from cylindrical or spherical contact compulsorily in the examination.
Traversing the tree from the leaf node to the root node is called as vortex.
Are you noting down, Mithun, Sukrut, Danush?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
What is a binary tree with only right subtrees called as? What is a binary tree with only right subtrees called as?
If you have finished, we will go to the next page.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, note down contact patch of width A. and note down the values of M1 and M2 there itself, okay? 1 minus nu1 square by E1, M2 is 1 minus nu2 square by E2. Finished, yeah? Finished?
Yes, sir.
Shall we go to the problem now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah. Take down this problem. This was also around 10 marks. An overhead crane wheel. Please note down. An overhead crane wheel runs slowly. An overhead crane wheel runs slowly on a steel rail. Okay. On a steel rail. Nothing. There is a wheel of the crane which will run on a steel rail. Okay. That is, the wheel will run on a steel rail. Okay. So steel rail is always flat. Keep that in mind. Okay. Now, what is the size of the contact patch? Size of contact patch. That is the value of size of contact patch between wheel and rail, and what are the stresses? What is the depth of maximum shear stress is asking you? Okay. Given data. Wheel diameter is 304.8 millimeter. Wheel thickness is 22.2 mm. So rail is flat. So rail is flat. Therefore, your R2 is going to be 0. Okay. And radial load is 22,248 newton. Have you noted down the problem? Have you noted down?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please look into the problem now. I'll go through the problem. An overhead crane wheel runs slowly on a steel rail. So that is, you have a wheel that is runs on a rail. Okay, so this is R2, okay? So for rail, it is the R2. And for the wheel, it is radius is R1, okay? So we are given with wheel diameter of 304.8. So you can extract R1 from there, okay? What is the size of the contact patch? So what is the size of contact patch between the wheel and the flat rail? Okay, that's what we need to find. So we have got contact patch equation given by A is equal to root of 2 by pi into M1 plus M2 by B into F into L. So we know the value of F, we know the value of thickness, that is L value we know here, 22.2. M1 and M2 is 1 minus nu square by E and 1 minus nu2 square by E. So we take, since he says material is same for both wheel and rail here, okay? on contact patch between wheel and rail, maximum shear stress, and we need to find M1 and M2, taking them to be of same material. So new, if he has not given you, take it as 0.28, and since it is steel, 2 × 10^5 can be taken for Young's modulus. Okay, so R2 is 0 because rail is flat. So find out the value of B, value of M1, M2, substitute here, and you will get the value of A. Is that okay? Complete this problem and let me know the answer. Why L is 22.2 is wheel thickness, okay? That is the length of contact patch, okay? That is, if you look at the figure over here, what is that we took? Okay, this is the length L, okay? So that is essentially the wheel thickness which is in contact, okay? Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
If you are finished, we'll go to the next page. Have you finished calculating?
We have to include square root for F by L.
Square root for F by L. L. Yes, yes. Totally, it's under square root.
Okay, sir.
What is the answer of A?
1.339.
1.339. Okay. 1.33. That's what I've taken. 1.34. Okay. Anybody not getting this value?
Scott, sir. 1.39.
Okay, fine. Okay, here 3.28 into 5. 1.339 you got. Next, moving on to, now we need to find out the average pressure. Okay, then we have to find out P max, because it is 1.273 times P average, because that's what we have taken over here during derivation. Okay, P average is this is the one. Okay, P max is 1.273 times P average is P max. Okay, so we need to find out P max also. So to find P max, we need to find P average, that is equal to force by area. Okay, area is 2 into A into L. So A is 1.339, we found out the length of the patch is 22.2. So get area, then P average. Sigma Z max is minus of P max. This we have taken in spherical contact itself. So same thing holds good over here. And then depth at maximum shear stress is 0.7786 times the contact patch A. Is that okay? So find out sigma Y max and find out tau max and depth at tau max. Please calculate these values. What is the value of sigma Y max, tau Y max? Depth at tau max is 0.786 multiplied by 1.34. It is 480. Are you getting these values? Tau max and depth.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
What is sigma Y max?
269.192 minus.
Minus 2. How much?
269.192.
269.2. Okay. So right, we'll take the next problem. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, take the next problem. An overhead crane wheel runs slowly. This is a different question. Okay. An overhead crane wheel runs slowly on a steel rail. Okay, again here, R2 is 0 because steel rail is a flat one, it's infinite value. 1 by infinity is going to be 0. What is the size of the contact patch? That is the value of what? Value of contact patch. Please note down this problem, then we will go through that. Wheel and rail, and what are the stresses? What is the depth of maximum shear stress? Wheel is 250 mm diameter and 20 mm thick. Rail is flat, both parts are made of steel. The radial load is 18,000 Newton. Poisson's ratio is 0.28, Young's modulus is 2.1 into 10 power 5 Newton per mm square. Note down this problem. Have you noted down this problem? Noted, Sukrut, Mithun, Danush.
Noted. Yes, sir.
Noted, So again, it's a steel rail. R2 is going to be 0. You have to find out contact patch. That is the value of A you have to find out. And wheel diameter is 250 mm given in the problem. Correct, So that's going to give you the value of R1. Correct? Okay. That is 125 mm. And 20 mm thick. So that will give you the value of what? That will give you the value of L, and this will give you the value of R1, and rail is flat, so R2 is going to be 0. Radial load, this will give you the value of F, and you are given with nu and Young's modulus values. So can you find out the remaining things? What are the stresses? What is the depth of maximum shear stress? That's what you get here. Okay, tau max, depth at tau max is 0.786 times A. Okay, then find out P max, find out stresses in Z, Y, and X directions. Solve the problem now. More or less, it is similar to previous problem, no? Okay. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Complete the problem fast. Complete this problem.
E is 21, sir?
No, it is 2.1 into 10 power 5. See, always for steel, you take it as 2 into 10 power 5. So here he has given you 2.1. It will never be 21 into 10 power 5. Okay, na?
Okay, sir.
Yeah. Is it noisy from you, for you, from my side?
No, sir.
Okay, because somebody is grinding. So if you, it's disturbing, I'll mute my audio for some time.
Sir, radial rod is 18,000 or 15,000, sir?
18,000, 18, 18.
Okay.
What is the answer?
Yeah, 1.12.
Yeah, is 1.14. Maybe is 1.12.
Yes, sir.
Then it's fine. What about B value?
B value 4 × 10⁻³.
Okay, that's fine. M 1 and M 2 4.6 × 10⁻⁶.
Yes, sir.
Slight variation will be there because I have taken 2 here instead of 2.1.
4.38.
Okay. So here you get 1.12, correct? A value.
Yes, sir.
Next, stresses.
P average is 401.1.
P average is 401, correct, okay. That's fine.
Sir, P max is 510.4, sir.
That's excellent, okay. That's correct.
Sigma y max is -286.
-280, okay, that's fine. I'm curious with the depth of maximum shear stress.
Sir, 0.88.
0.88, yeah, I got 0.86. So 0.88 should be okay. So it is 0.88, fine. Okay, surely there will be one question out of these contacts, okay? They especially problem, okay? Keep in mind. Others, other two finished, huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Finished, huh? Anybody else still to do? Mithun, Sukrut, Danush, all the three finished, huh?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. So before we go to general contact, that I think we can take it up in the next class. So what we did was, we learnt about cylindrical contact. It's essentially two cylinders rolling over each other, and at the point of contact we'll get maximum pressure, and then we derived the derivations for P max, and then the constant, say geometry constant B, and then we learnt about contact patch A equation. And then we utilized or applied those equations in learning what is the actual contact patch in case of a crane wheel or a rail wheel, okay? So which is traveling on a steel rail. So what is going to be the contact patch? What is going to be the depth at which shear stress is going to be maximum, okay? So these are the things that we learned. So we are learning about contact patches, correct? Okay. Are you there?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay, then I think next class we'll take up a general contact and then move on to the dynamic contact stresses, second topic of module 5. Okay, and in the meantime, after completion of this, I'll send these two notes to your mails. Okay, now. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Okay, sir.
Okay, then we'll meet.